Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and in this episode we have a mock-up of a real spy artifact, since, to the best of our knowledge, there hasn't been any publicly available instance of this device. We're talking about something that looked exactly like this. How is this a spy device, you might ask? The United States National Security Agency's Advanced Network Technology, or ANT division, was designing and manufacturing those to spy on computers. Basically, NSA operatives were, and potentially still are, intercepting shipments of hardware to their targets, or even physically infiltrating their facilities to replace the hardware's connectors with these. And let's be honest here, no one was going to think that in the connector of their device there is actually a highly sophisticated bug. Now, in case you aren't aware, at NSA, the largest directorate is the SIGINT one, and the people tasked with collecting signals intelligence, or SIGINT, is the S3, the data acquisition. A very small office under S3 is the tailored access operations. This is a small group of NSA hackers that, when the only option to collect the required intel is by developing advanced bugs, hacking into networks that the existing NSA's capabilities couldn't do, and so on, TAO takes the lead. And part of this TAO office was, and potentially still is, also the ANT, that is the brain behind this bug. And how we got to know that is because in 2013 a catalogue of ANT's products was leaked online that was unrelated to the Snowden leaks that were happening around the same time. The catalogue included several capabilities that ANT was able to provide to the NSA, including this, the FIREWALK. FIREWALK was a bidirectional network implant capable of passively collecting gigabit Ethernet network traffic and actively injecting Ethernet packets onto the same target network. We also read that FIREWALK is a bidirectional, for that bandwidth, Ethernet network implant residing within a dual stack RJ45 USB connector. This, in other words, FIREWALK is capable of filtering and egressing network traffic over a custom RF link and injecting traffic as commanded. This allows an Ethernet tunnel, VPN, to be created between target network and remote operation center, or an intermediate redirector node such as DNT's Dunder's Bridge tool. FIREWALK allows active exploitation of a target network with a firewall or air gap protection. There is a diagram to help us understand this better. This is NSA's ROC, Remote Operation Center, and this is the target's network, which is assumed to be protected by firewalls or to be air-gapped, meaning it has no direct access to the internet or other public networks. As explained, NSA operatives physically replace this connector with FIREWALK either by intercepting the shipment or have direct or indirect access to the physical infrastructure. Once connected to the network, FIREWALK captures all, or what it was configured to capture, network traffic that passes through this system, and then it uses HowlerMonkey to transmit it using RF emissions. Basically, HowlerMonkey is a miniaturized RF transceiver designed by NSA's ANT and embedded in FIREWALK. We know that because it was also part of this leaked catalogue. Here, HowlerMonkey is a commercial off-the-shelf based transceiver designed to be compatible with conjecture speculation networks and strike zone devices running a HowlerMonkey personality. PCB layouts are tailored to individual implant space requirements and can vary greatly in form factor. And just this module had a cost of around $750 per unit, assuming an order for 40 of them. And why would you need that many? Going back to FIREWALK, let's read that. FIREWALK uses the HowlerMonkey transceiver for the backend communications. It can communicate with a listening post or other compatible HowlerMonkey-based ANT products to increase RF range through multiple hops. Let's assume that FIREWALK was installed in some remote military facility in China or Iran or another country. In the simplest case, it won't transmit anything. It will just inject malicious packets in the network traffic to spread some NSA malware in the whole restricted network. But if the goal was to intercept traffic, and assuming NSA managed to get 40 of those systems implanted with Firewalk all around this facility, they can actually relay the traffic among them using their HowlerMonkey chips. This means NSA will only need one of those to have access to another network, or an external storage device, or other means to exfiltrate that traffic. Another option is what NSA called LHR, Long Haul Relay, where NSA hackers had two options on how to receive those RF signals from HowlerMonkey. The first is to be in the proximity of those emissions with a field network. Then they could use something like their ProTOS, which was a computer to receive and collect those HowlerMonkey signals. The other option was to remotely hack a device in the proximity of those emissions. Think of a nearby building, maybe maintenance personnel that goes in and out, another system that is installed near this military facility and so on, to infect it with the same implant and then use it to relay those back to the NSA's ROC. At that time, when TAEO was doing those targeted hacking activities, they were using a framework to remotely manage those compromised systems, codenamed Dunder's Bridge. And as we read, the prototype of Firewalk was ready in August of 2008 with a cost of $537,000 for 50 units. That's nearly $11,000 per unit. Also, now you know why ordering 50 of them makes more sense. For each diagram, the Netherlands-based Crypto Museum did a far more refined version of it. And it's this diagram where we see that the heart of this hardware implant, as those types of bugs are officially called, was another NSA innovative spy tech, codenamed Trinity. Unfortunately for the NSA, that was also leaked. It's this. Trinity is a miniaturized digital core packaged in a multi-chip module, MCM, to be used in implants with size-constraining concealments. And as per its description, Trinity uses the TAEO standard implant architecture. The architecture provides a robust, reconfigurable, standard digital platform, resulting in a dramatic performance improvement over the obsolete HC12 microcontroller-based designs. A development printed circuit board, PCB, using packaged parts has been developed and is available as the standard platform. The Trinity MCM contains an ARM9 microcontroller, FPGA, flash, and SDRAM memories. Let's pause for a moment and think of this. What we've just seen is 17-year-old spy technology. Repeating that, 17 years old. It's equally remarkable that to this day there hasn't been any publicly known case of systems implanted with Firewalk. We can be quite certain that in the 5 years between 2008 and 2013 when it was leaked, NSA had some operational use of it. And probably, after this disclosure, the targets might have discovered it. However, no such case has been publicly disclosed to this day. And even if a network is completely air-gapped, without any connection to external systems, Firewalk could spy on its network traffic, or even inject malicious software as we've just seen. And if you are curious how something like that could be defeated, it's actually under the scope of something usually referred to as Tempest in Western countries. That is, shielding sensitive systems from all emissions that can reveal information. That includes Faraday cages in sensitive rooms, white noise and vibrations between walls, electronic cases with additional shields to reduce RF emissions and so on. Actually, if you've ever been to a SCIF, then you know exactly what this looks like in practice. Furthermore, nation states test all hardware that is installed in secure facilities to certify it. When testing, they are actually looking for Tempest issues, as well as hardware implants like Firewalk. In reality though, many nation states do those certifications either by just sampling, or outsourcing, or just doing the bare minimum to put a check on a compliance checkbox. So it's not a truly foolproof process. Not to mention that NSA operatives could also install those after the devices got certified. The whole point of this Tempest hardening is that even if such RF emissions occur, they won't propagate outside of that secure room. But the innovation of Firewalk was both its relay functionality and configurability, because on-site recon could have revealed that some frequencies might be going through the implemented Tempest controls, or just that there is a computer that someone placed there for convenience right outside the target room, which could receive those Firewalk emissions, and NSA could use that as a relay to escape the air-gapped network. You might have heard that security experts always say that you can never be absolutely certain about your security posture, and Firewalk is a great example of that. Sophisticated actors can go to great lengths to collect intelligence, making inconspicuous objects, like a network connector, into advanced covert listening devices, and managing to physically install them into highly secure facilities. And it's why we always say that nothing is as it seems.